Hello, my dear friends. Today we are going to see this Hamiltonian cycle problem, and we'll see how this backtracking approach is useful to solve this Hamiltonian cycle problem. So the statement says that we have given an undirected graph and two nodes X and Y. Then find a path from X and Y visiting each node in the graph exactly once. It means we'll have to start from A. So we'll have a given a graph here itself. Okay. So we'll have to start traversing from this node A. And by traversing each node exactly once, we'll have to come back in this node A itself. So X and Y is nothing, it is an A itself. But we'll have to take care of, while visiting this, all vertices, that they should be traversed only once, and we'll have to move back to A itself. So if any graph which contains this Hamiltonian cycle, then the graph will be known as Hamiltonian graph. So to solve this problem, we are going to use backtracking algorithm itself. Okay. First of all, we'll have to take care of that one, that the graph should contain a Hamiltonian cycle. So how we are going to identify that a graph is containing the Hamiltonian cycle or not? So let's take an example. So this is a graph given to us. Okay, so we have this vertices here. We have these vertices. Now we start moving from this one. So, and we will have to come back here itself by traversing each node only once. So if I will start from here, I will go there. See, I have traversed all the nodes, but I am not able to come back to this node itself here. So this will not going to be a Hamiltonian cycle. Now again, considering to that, now let's see if we'll have a graph given like this one. This graph is containing Hamiltonian cycle or not? We'll start from here itself. Okay. We'll move back to here. So again, we'll see that we are not able to come back to here itself. If we want to come back, we'll have to traverse this intermediate node twice, and it is not the definition of Hamiltonian cycle. While coming back to here, we'll have to make sure that each vertices will be traversed and only once. Let's try to traverse here itself. So I will start from A, A to B, B to F, so A to B, B to F, F to E, E to C, C to D, and now D to A. Other paths are also possible. I have shown you here only one path, single path itself. So this is the problem statement. Okay, and we'll going to solve this problem by using backtracking algorithm. See, we are going to apply this backtracking algorithm. So the state space tree is generated in order to find Hamiltonian cycle. Using backtracking algorithm, the Hamiltonian cycle can be obtained. The statement is saying like this one. Okay, so in nutshell, what we are doing? So we have given a graph. And we have to find the Hamiltonian circuit using backtracking approach. So we'll start our search from an arbitrary vertex, say A. From here we are going to start. This vertex A becomes the root of our implicit tree. So we are going to design a tree here itself. We are going to make a tree like this one. Okay, we are going to make a tree. The first element of our passive solution is the first intermediate vertex of the Hamiltonian cycle that is to be constructed. The next adjacent vertex is selected by alphabetical order. So the next note is going to be decided. How it is going to be decided? It should be the adjacent node of this A itself. So we have this B, we have this C, and we have this D. Any alphabetical order we can say. We can take from B, C, D, we can take from B, C, D. The only condition that we'll have to take care that it should be adjacent of A. Adjacent of A itself. It means they should be directly connected to this A itself. Okay. If at any stage any arbitrary vertex makes a cycle with any vertex other than A, then we say that dead end is reached. It means we'll have to come back to the A itself. Otherwise we'll get a stuck as earlier in earlier problem we have solved this. See this one. Okay, we have seen here itself. Okay. So in this case, we backtrack one step and again the search begins by selecting other vertex and backtrack the element from the past here. Okay, so we'll have to backtrack. If we'll stuck, we'll have to backtrack again. So if I'll write here a B, here if I'll write C, here if we'll write D, so what to do? We'll have to backtrack. If in any path we'll get stuck, we'll have to backtrack. Again we'll come back here. Again we'll have to backtrack. We'll see the example itself. Okay. So hope this definition is clearer to you here itself. What we are going to do, we'll have to traverse. We'll start from A. We'll have to traverse each node only once. And we'll have to come back in this node itself. Okay. So let's see an example. So this is an example given here. So we'll start from, we are going to consider this graph. So we'll start from A, from here we are going to start. This is A, this is root node. Now the adjacent nodes are B, C, D. So I have written from here itself, B, C, D. You can write from here also, B, C, D. So it can be write from anywhere. Okay. Now see, I'm showing you here the results are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the feasible solutions which we can get. So from graph it can be clearly visible. If we'll start from B, F, E, C, D, A. That will be the result. Okay. The result can be A, B, C, A, D, E, F, B, C, A. So this will be the result. Okay. It will be clearly visible from here itself. So at last we'll have to come back A. See, these are the solution set. We have considered here only the answer sets. Okay. So other sets are also present here, but we have discarded right now. We'll see a detailed example later. Okay. So this is A. The adjacent node to this A is B, C, D. So we have this section. This section is here. We have this section. Again, now see what is the adjacent of D. Adjacent of D nodes is what? Adjacent of D node is C, E, and A. A is already traversed. A is already traversed. So we are going to take care of that C and E. So I have written C and E. Okay, now again we are going to concentrate this C itself, and we'll move like this process. Okay, so we'll see in a detailed example of this one. So this is the way, this is the approach which we are going to follow while making a state space tree diagram. Okay, let's see a detailed example of that one. So these are the possible solutions. So this is the problem statement which is given to us. Okay, let's see a graph. Okay. The question says find the Hamiltonian circuit using backtracking method. So we have to apply backtracking method. So we'll have to take care of, so what? We'll have to take care of the adjacent nodes. So for adjacent node, we can make an adjacency matrix also. You can make an adjacency matrix and write 1 and 0 over there. You can make an adjacency matrix here itself. For how many nodes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 1, 2, three, four, five, six, successively here also. Two, three, four, five, six. So for if we'll start from A, so A is one. If A is one, so A to B, A to C, A to D, we have a path. Okay. So that is if 1 to 1 is what? 1 to 1 is what? 0. Okay. 1 to 2 is what? B. That is 1 to B is having 1. 1 to C, C is third. Okay, so we have 1. D is 4. Again we have 1. So you can make this matrices itself. So by seeing this matrix you can easily come to know that there is a dedicated path or not. Or the vertex are adjacent to that vertex or not. So you can make this adjacency matrix, and once you have this matrix, it is very easy to implement this graph concept itself. That is Hamiltonian graph or Hamiltonian cycle. Okay, let's see an example how we are going to make a state space tree diagram for this one. So we'll have to take care of adjacent nodes. Okay, so this is the Hamiltonian cycle. So we'll start from an arbitrary vertex, that is A. We are taking here A. You can take any vertex. Okay, so I am taking here A itself. Okay, so we start from this A. A is given here, so A is the root node. Okay, so the adjacent vertex for this A is B, C, D. So I have this B, C, and D. These are the adjacent vertices. Okay, so now we are going to consider this B. Why? Because we are using DFS. So we'll take care of this B. So what is the adjacent node of this B? For B is A, C, D. So for this B we have C, A and E. C, A and E. Okay. A is already traversed. So we are going to take B and we are going to take this C and E. So this is C and E. Now let's take care of this C. So the adjacent node to this C is D, A, B, E. So as A and B is already traversed, so we are going to consider this D and E. So B and A is already traversed, so we are going to take care of this B and E. Now again, from D, what are the adjacent nodes? For D, the adjacent nodes are C, A, E, and F. Okay, so the traverse nodes are C, B, A. We are not going to take care of that one. So the node which is not traversed right now is E and F. That is E and F, which is not traversed yet right now. Okay. Now we are going to take care of this E. E. So from where E, what are the adjacent nodes? B, C, D, and F. Okay. So the nodes which is the adjacent to this B, C, D and F, B, C, D is already traversed. We can see from here. This is B, C and B. They are traversed already. So we are left with only what? F. So we'll take F. While taking this F, now see, what are the adjacent nodes of this F? D and E. And D and E is already traversed. D and E is already traversed. So we are going to ignore this one. Now we'll backtrack from here itself and we'll move there, D. Now from D, we again move forward and we'll have an option of F. We'll taking care of this F. So what are the adjacent node of this F? Is again D and E. D is traversed, so we are going to take care of this E. While taking this E, what are the adjacent node of this E? E is having C, B, D and F. So the nodes that are the adjacent of this E is already traversed. Okay, so we are going to cancel this one. Again we will backtrack from here and we will move here itself in C section. Now from C, what are the adjacent node of this C? C adjacent node is E, B, A and D. Okay, so the adjacent node of C is what? E, B, B and A. Okay, so we are going to take that E itself. First of all, E, as D is from C, C, D is already traversed. D is already traversed. One second. Okay, see, D is already traversed here. So we are not going to take this one. We are taking this E itself. Okay, E is going to be considered here. For E, what we have? We have B, C, D and F. Okay. So C and B is already traversed. So we are left with this D and F. We are going to take this D and F. D. D and F. Okay. So for this D, what will happen? Again, we'll have to take the adjacent node of this one. D. Adjacent node of this D is what? C, A, E and F. We are left with only F itself because E, C and A are traversed. E, C and A are traversed. Okay. So, we are going to take this F. Now from again F, we have E and D is the adjacent node and they are already traversed. So, again it is not going to make circuit. Again from here, we will have to backtrack here from E. Okay. Now E will come back to here. F. What will happen in this F section? What is the adjacent node of this F? F, E and D. E and D. As E is already traversed. E is already traversed. So we'll take care of this D itself. Okay. From D, what are the adjacent node of this D? C, E, F, A. So, C, E, sorry, we are taking care of this F itself now. Sorry, D. Okay, we are here. D. So, for D, we have A, C, E, F. So, A is traversed. E is traversed. C is traversed, F is traversed, and A. So, A. So, we have a circuit from here itself. And it is clearly visible that all the adjacent nodes are visited. So, A is visited. So, the path is what? So, the path is what? See, this is the path. A. To B, A to B, B to C, we have B to C, we have C to E, we have C to E, we have E to F, we have E to F, we have F to D, we have F to D, and we have D to A, we have D to A. So, this will create a circuit here. Circuit means cycle. Okay. So we have started from A and we'll come back to A by visiting each node only once. So try to understand, we'll have to take care of vertices, not the edges. There is not requirement of visiting all the edges. We'll have to visit all the vertices. So by following this way, we are going to construct whole tree. Okay. So this is an Hamiltonian. So these are the possible solutions. So these are the possible solutions, which is clearly visible in the diagram also. So these are the possible solutions. Okay. Hope this topic is clearer to you. Okay. Thanks.